John Wilkes. It's a grand day you'll be having for the barbecue.
So it seems, General. But why is Mrs. O'Hara with you?
She's after settling accounts with the overseer, but she'll be along for the ball tonight.
Welcome to 12 Oaks, Mr. O'Hara.
Thank you kindly, India. Your daughter's getting prettier every day, John.
Oh, India, here are the O'Hara girls. We must greet them.
Can't stand that Scarlett. If you'd see the way she throws herself at Ashley.
No, that's your brother's business. You must remember your duties as hostess. Good morning, girls.
Lovely.
Good morning, Scarlett.
India Wilkes. What a lovely dress.
Looking lovely.
Just can't take my eyes off it.
Good morning, Scarlett.
I've been looking for you everywhere. I've got something I must tell you. Can't we go someplace where it's quiet?
Yes, I'd like to, but I have something to tell you, too. Something I hope you'll be glad to hear. Come and say hello to my cousin Melanie first.
Oh, do we have to?
She's been looking forward to seeing you again. Melanie. Here's Scarlett.
Scarlett. I'm so glad to see you. Melanie Hamilton, what a surprise to run into you here. I hope you're going to stay with us a few days at least.
I hope I shall stay longer enough for us to become real friends, Scarlett. I do so want us to be.
We'll keep her here, won't we, Scarlett?
Oh, we'll just have to make a bigger fuss over her, won't we, Ashley? And if there's anybody who knows how to give a girl a good time, it's Ashley. Though I expect our good time to seem terribly silly to you because you're so serious.
Oh, Scarlett, you have so much life. I've always admired you so. I wish I could be more like you.
You mustn't flatter me, Melanie, and say things you don't mean.
Nobody could accuse Melanie of being insincere. Could they, my dear?
Oh, well, then she's not like you, is she, Ashley? Ashley never means a word he says to any girl. Oh, why, Charles Hamilton, you handsome old thing, you.
But, oh, Miss O'Hara.
Do you think that was kind to bring your good-looking brother down here just to break my poor, simple country girl's heart?
Look at Scarlett. You never even noticed Charles before. Now, just because it's your beau, she's after him like a hornet.
Charles Hamilton, I want to eat barbecue with you. And mind you don't go philandering with any other girl, because I'm mighty jealous.
I won't, Miss O'Hara. I couldn't.
I do declare, Frank Kennedy, you don't look dashing with that new set of whiskers.
Oh, thank you, Miss Scarlett.
You know, Charles Hamilton and Rafe Cabot asked me to eat barbecue with them, but I told him I couldn't because I promised you.
Well, you needn't be so amused. Look at her. She's after your beau now.
Oh, that's mighty flattering of you, Miss Scarlett. I'll see what I can do, Miss Scarlett.
What's your sister so mad about, Scarlett? You're sparking her beau?
As if I couldn't get a better beau than that old maiden Bridges.
Brent and Stuart Tarzan, you handsome old things. You... Oh, no, you're not. I'm not going to say that. I'm mad at you.
What have we done, honey?
You haven't been near me all day, and I wore this old dress just because I thought you liked it. I was counting on eating barbecue with you, too.
Well, you are, Scarlett. Of course you are, honey.
Oh, I never can make up my mind which of you two's the handsomest. I was awake all last night trying to figure it out.
Oh,
shucks.
I'm sorry.
Kathleen, who's there?
Who?
That man looking at us and smiling. The nasty dog.
My dear, don't you know? That's Red Butler. He's from Charleston. He has a most terrible reputation.
He looks as if he knows what I look like without my shimmy.
Scarlett! But my dear, he isn't received. He's had to spend most of his time up north because his folks in Charleston won't even speak to him. He was expelled from West Point, he's so fast. And then there's that business about that girl he wouldn't marry.
Tell.
Well, he took her out buggy riding in the late afternoon without a chaperone, and then he refused to marry her. No, but she was ruined just the same.